Good evening, Gigi, miss.
Good evening, Anjana.
Good evening. I'm audible, no, miss?
Yes, you are. You are. It is being streamed live now, okay, teachers? We'll just
good evening, miss.
Good evening. We'll wait for the guest and others also to join, and then we will start.
Good evening, Father.
Yes.
I think Father Anil has joined. Hello, Father. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you, Father?
I'm good, good. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Good evening, Father.
Good evening.
Let's wait 5 more minutes, Father.
Yeah. Okay, that's okay. That's okay. I'll be here.
Okay.
May I know if Dwani has joined? Dwani? Mr. Manoj, miss, may I know if Dwani has joined?
Let me confirm. I have to check. I'll call the parent.
I don't find her.
Even I can't see. I called her. She told me she
yeah.
Called her.
think Father Davis also has joined. Father Davis? Good evening, Father. Most welcome.
I am here. Good evening.
Most welcome, Father.
We are starting now, no?
Yes. Father Santo, shall we start? Father Santo, shall we start?
Yes, let's start. Let's start.
Thank you, Father. Thank you. May I hand over the mic to Archer Ranjit Miss, who will be the MC of today's program.
Thank you, ma'am. Good evening to everyone. I would like to welcome you all for the auspicious day of National Science Day and honor Sir C.V. Raman, who discovered the Raman effect. Generally, the program aims to highlight the achievement of famous Indian scientist Sir C.V. Raman, who won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1930. Today, even though kindergarten students are yet to learn more about C.V. Raman, the program today highlights the curiosity the students have to explore the world and in doing experiments. The National Science Day creates the awareness about the importance of science in the daily life of people. Today, our dear children are going to demonstrate the experiments that they have been learning in UKG. Also, they will exhibit the new and innovative creations of the live models, sharks, what they have learned in explorations UKG. Let me quote a famous quote by Sir C.V. Raman. Success can come to you by courageous devotion to the task lying in front of you. So from this famous quote, whatever you get, grab it, own it, test it, and implement it with all the devotion and dedication. It's a great pleasure this evening to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Father Anil George Konkon CMI, our principal, Reverend Father Sunny Puneli Paramil CMI, our vice principal, Reverend Father Sinto Nangani CMI, our provincial achar, our UKG coordinator, Mr. G, teachers, parents, grandparents, and our dear tiny tots. I welcome everybody for this virtual Science Day explorations fun, and I wish the beautiful creations make you cheerful, filled with joy and happy memories of your child. Such celebrations are wonderful and interesting medium to explain various things at the same time, and it's a great platform for the students to explore, experiment, and learn the concept. So let's enjoy the event. Prayer has no expiration date. You never know when, where, or how God will answer. So let's begin this event with a prayer song by Dwini of UKG Lotus.
Thank you.
thank you, Dhvani, for your lovely prayer song. With immense happiness, I call upon our UKG coordinator for the welcome speech.
Thank you, Asha Miss. Respected and honored guest of the day, Reverend Dr. Anil Konkot CMI, our provincial Reverend Dr. Davis Panikil CMI, Principal Reverend Father Sunny Punelli Parambil CMI, Vice Principal Reverend Father Sinto Nangini CMI, PTWA representative of UKG, Ms. Smita John, the executive members of the PTWA, ACMI members, special invitees, well-wishers, grandparents and parents, teachers and non-teaching staff of Devamatha, and most importantly, the young stars and the budding scientists of today's program. A very good evening and a warm welcome to one and all present here virtually. Ask the right questions and nature will open the doors to her secrets. The famous quote by the prominent scientist C.V. Raman, whose discovery of Raman effect that we commemorate today, the 28th of February, is so aptly said. We all celebrate this day as a National Science Day. And as Asha has said, the main objective of National Science Day is to bring awareness to people about the importance of science in our daily life. And every year, most of the schools and other educational institutions organizes various activities like science fairs, quizzes, debates, and so many. And yes, we at kindergarten too celebrates Science Day in a different format. Our students, right from the LKG, have hands-on experience of science-related concepts like germination of seed, experiments with colors, air and water experiments, soluble and insoluble, and much more. These experiments were also held during the last 2 years on the online classes. And this evening, the upper kindergarten students of Devamatha are proud and confident to demonstrate the virtual science experiments where young budding scientists will showcase the static and the working models which can be used for learning various scientific concepts. It is said that everything is theoretically impossible unless it is done. And when it comes to kids, curious minds would love to explore, experience, experiment, and enrich themselves. And this also leads them to confident learners through hands-on activities. Yes, respected fathers, ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor that this beautiful ambience we have gathered here virtually for the confidence that we provide to the enriching minds of our schools. And let me first of all thank each one of you for giving us this precious time to watch the young scientists perform today. With this note, let me accord an official welcome to each one of you. On this note, here we have our honorable chief guest of this evening, Reverend Dr. Anil George Konkot CMI, who is presently the assistant professor in the computer department of the reputed St. Thomas College, Thrissur. A genius by himself and a doctorate holder who has achieved his PhD in the title, A Fuzzy Enabled Neural Learning Paradigm for Prediction of Acute Myocardial Infarction from Anna University, Chennai. Father Anil also holds the position as the chairperson of Ethics Committee of Amala Research Center, Thrissur, and also a member of Board of Studies at the University of Calicut, and of course, Devamatha. An expertise in his subject, Father Anil has conducted innumerable seminars, workshops, and webinars as a resource person to various colleges, universities, and in national level conferences too. Adding a few more feathers to his hat, he's the National Life Member of Science Congress of India and the Computer Society of India. His research activities include many publications, one of which that has been published in UK too. And I come across that he still continues to enrich himself on his faculty department programs. He has coordinated and convened so many enrichment programs, both in state and in national level. The list is endless. Father Anil has bought Innovations teaching learning platforms like Moodle platforms, ICT learning, and flipped classrooms. And Father Anil's presentations on various conferences are indeed noteworthy. I'm extremely overwhelmed to get this opportunity to welcome the genius of the Devamatha province and of this magnitude for our Science Day celebrations here today. On behalf of Devamatha family, may I cordially and respectfully welcome our chief guest, Reverend Dr. Anil George Kongot CMI, who connects young minds to strive towards success and achievement. We are grateful to you, Father, for accepting our invitation. A very hearty welcome, dear Father. Now, it's my ardent pleasure to welcome our dear manager, Reverend Dr. Davis Panikkal CMI, for his gracious presence. Your steady, hands-on, deep faith, courage of convictions, vibrant spirituality, and unwavering commitment to your mission and determined efforts to take everyone along in the realization of God's plan makes you a very special leader, Father, the provincial of Devamatha province and also the manager of our school. We welcome you, Father. The courage to make tough decisions and the compassion to listen to the need of others is an art. Our dear principal, Reverend Father Sunny Puneli Parambil CMI, becomes a special leader by the equality of his action and the integrity of his intent. Let us all welcome our dear principal with a virtual applause. On this great evening, with merging of minds, it's my pleasure to extend a gracious and inclusive welcome to our enthusiastic and respected vice principal, Reverend Father Sinto Nangani CMI. Hearty welcome, dear Father. To the world, you may be one person, but to one person, you may be the world. With immense pleasure, we heartily welcome all our PTW representatives who leads our great parents. With immense happiness, may I welcome Ms. Mita John, our UKG representative, who will felicitate on this important day. Hearty welcome, ma'am. ACMI has a special relationship with Devamatha. Your goodwill and positive vibration has a great impact in molding ourselves for the integral dimensions of the growth of this institution. I accord a hearty welcome to all the members of ACMI. Grandparents and parents are the world for children, as I said earlier. Not to overlook that we are here, joined by the wonderful members of the family who have raised the best students this school possesses. With immense admiration and affection, we welcome all the grandparents and parents who will watch their stars shine. I'd also like to accord a cordial welcome to all the coordinators of our school, teachers of Devamatha School, technical staff, and especially to all our dear confident students who are eagerly waiting to present their skills today and to make this program worthwhile. Let me wish all the science enthusiasts the very best to enhance their scientific zeal. Let me wind up my welcome note with a quote of Sir Albert Einstein. The most beautiful thing we can experience is the mysterious. It is the source of all true art and science. Have a wonderful evening, ladies and gentlemen. Take care, stay safe, and God bless each one of you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your warm welcome. It's my privilege to heartily welcome our esteemed guest, Dr. Father Anil George Kongot CMI, to this very special day. Father, this evening you will witness our tiny thoughts unveil their little treasures and their happy moments on their achievements. We are so glad about your presence, and it gives me immense pleasure to invite you to switch on Explorations Fund Science Day, and thus officially inaugurating this memorable day for us. And also, may I invite you to address the students and parents on their memorable day.
Good evening, everyone. Hope I am audible to you all.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So, respected Reverend Dr. Davis Panikkal, our beloved provincial and manager, Reverend Father Sunny, our beloved principal, Reverend Father Sindo, vice principal, Miss Gigi, UKG coordinator, Miss Mida John, the parents representative, Miss Anjana Anand, and all my dear little tots who are eagerly waiting to showcase your wonderful presentations on this occasion, dear parents and most beloved grandparents, and all my dear friends and all beloved teachers who have taken so much of pain to bring out, you know, to make this show of talent and you know, research aptitude of the budding scientists of Devamatha. Good evening to one and all. I feel, you know, very honored to be part of this beautiful program. This is truly, you know, amazing, a truly meaningful event to organize an event for the young, you know, the little thoughts to imbibe, to incorporate the science aptitude or the scientific temper among the growing new generation. I am told this is commemorated in commemoration of Dr. C.V. Raman for his excellent scientific contributions to this world. Dr. C.V. Raman has a small connection to Thrissur. In fact, he was expected to be the chief guest at St. Thomas College in 1934 for its College Day celebrations, the college where I am teaching right now. But, you know, due to some ill health, he couldn't come, and he sent a letter, and I am having that letter with me. Maybe on some other occasion, I can show it to you. So he is so close to, you know, our land. He was a great scientist from our land. He is the pride of all Indians to that matter. And, you know, to commemorate or to organize an event of this sort is truly commendable. I should congratulate Principal and Gigi Ma'am and all the faculty members for having organized this wonderful event. This is truly meaningful, you know, because learning is becoming more and more innovative. You know, it is more of learning than of studying, you know. And it is more of learning than of more of teaching. The role of teachers is that of, you know, kind of a facilitator or a mentor. Learning is always learner-centric, that is student-centric. And that's what happens when students do something and learn. You know, we have different sorts of learning paradigms, like, you know, experiential learning. Ma'am was explaining different types of learning methodologies, like germination of seeds by the kids, and many more of that sort. And truly, these exercises, these kind of activities, you know, help them learn in true sense, because it gives lasting learning process in the kids. They never forget these things. They never ever forget. And it is a joy as well, you know, getting involved in such small activities, but a lot of learning takes place within these kids. So we have these paradigms of, you know, experiential learning, participative learning, and problem solving learning methodologies. And these are being, you know, so much focused in the emerging times at every section, at higher education, at schools, even at KG. And this at KG rarely happens, but I should, you know, commend and congratulate Devamatha School and KG section of Devamatha for, you know, doing such activities definitely help the kids, you know, to come up, to have an edge over their peers in other schools, I am sure. So when we at college sometimes, you know, think of doing such experiential learning paradigms, we have lots of, you know, limitations. So at times what we do, we take them for industrial visits and many more of that sort. But at schools, you do it in a much different way, very, very innovative and creative way. Sometimes you give exposure to some cultivation or agriculture activities, they never ever forget in their life. So once again, I congratulate all of you for taking up these kinds of methodologies in teaching learning process, because as I told you, this will create lasting impressions in their minds, which will learn much more vigorously than ever before with these kinds of methodologies and techniques. When it comes to this event called Exploration Fund, where the kids learn by doing, learning by doing. So this is truly a very, very relevant way of doing things, like role plays, making some small models, those things may truly count a lot. So I congratulate you, all of you, especially the teachers, the parents who stand by the kids, the grandparents with whom these kids at this age have much more affinity. They are much more friendly with the grandparents, and their facilitation helps a lot. So I congratulate, and I wish this will bring the intended rewards in the days to come. And with these brief words, I declare the Exploration Fund inaugurated. Thank you.
Thank you, Fund.
Thank you, Father. We are really fortunate to hear your inspiration words. Okay. Our provincial Dr. Davis Panikal CMI, Father, has given us greetings to everyone. So he's not able to join now. So he has given to each and every student's greetings for this important day. Okay, dear children? And even our principal also has sent his greetings to everyone, and he's greeted to help of the parents and family members. Now let us watch our dear students demonstrate experiments of what they learned in explorations. And for this exciting moment, I first call upon Aisha of UKG Carnesia to demonstrate colors experiment. Aisha,
are you there?
Sharmin is
me. Good evening.
Yes.
Good evening, miss.
One minute, miss. The video is not.
No here. Problem. Just turn on the video. Sharmin, ma'am, is there a problem with connectivity issues? In that case, we can present the video. Sharmin, ma'am, is there a problem while presenting the video?
I think I will present the video.
Yes, Radha, I think we can. Otherwise, we will.
Good evening. I'm going to do an experiment of colors. These are the primary colors: red, yellow, and blue. So, first, when we mix the primary colors, we get secondary colors. So now I'm going to put them in water. We get red water. We get yellow water. We get blue water. So these are the primary colors. We mix we get purple. When we mix red and yellow, we get orange. We mix yellow, we get green. So now these are the primary colors that make secondary colors. Thank you. Good enough.
Colors are the smiles of nature, and colors makes our life happier. Aisha, what a wonderful performance you put up. Keep it up, dear.
Thank you.
Next comes Srinav. Welcome. Next comes Srinav of UKG Jasmine, all set to demonstrate germination of seeds experiment.
Srinav, I think you need to unmute. You are visible.
Yes. Good evening. I am Srinav T.S. from UKG Jasmine to tell you the life cycle of the plant. This is the seed. So the seed in the soil. What are the seeds? After sunning, it becomes the plant. The plant is soil, water, sunlight and air to grow. Little seed for me to sow. Little earth to make it grow. Little hole, little back, little wish and that is what. Little sun, little shower and little white then flower. Thank you.
Success is just a seed that grows with every effort you do. Kudos to you, dear Srinav. Well explained about the germination of seeds. Guess who comes next? We have here Johanna UKG Lotus coming up with the water cycle experiment.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Continue.
Hey, everyone. Have you ever wondered how rain is formed? Rain is formed by the phenomenon known as water cycle. Let us learn water cycle with the help of an experiment. Take a big bowl with steaming hot water. Consider this bowl of water as the ocean water, which is heated up by the sun. You can see water vapor rising from the surface of hot water. This is called evaporation. Now keep a small empty bowl inside the big bowl of water. Now let us cover the bowl with the lid and put some ice over it. This will act as the clouds that can be seen in atmosphere. The water vapor pours down at the clouds and the clouds now hold the cool drops of water. This process is called condensation. After some time, you can see that just like the cloud, the lid can no more hold the drops of water. So, the drops start to fall down into the small empty bowl as rain. This process is called precipitation. After some time, when we open the lid, you can see small empty bowl filled with rain water. This water again gets evaporated, thus completing the water cycle. This water cycle consists of three phases: evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. Thank you.
A drop of water is worth than a sack of gold to a thirsty man. Well said, Johan, about the importance of water cycle. Let's lend our ears to our vice principal, Reverend Father Sinton Nangani CMI, to felicitate.
Chief guest of the day, Reverend Dr. Anil Pongat, professor at St. Thomas College. Reverend Dr. Davis Panakel CMI, manager and provincial. Reverend Father Sunny Punnelli Parambil, beloved principal, coordinator Ms. Gigi, respected teachers, beloved grandparents, parents, and my dear loving students. Good evening to one and all. Knowing is not enough. We must apply. Wishing is not enough. We must do. This is one of my favorite quotes. Knowing is not enough. We must apply. Wishing is not enough. We must do. This piece of wisdom reminds us to apply what we learn and take action towards success rather than waiting and hoping. Today, we gathered in this online platform to celebrate the National Science Day by exhibiting and presenting the talents of our tiny tots through Explorations Fund. I'm very happy that kindergarten students are getting always a platform to exhibit their talents. The main purpose of each exhibition or each presentation is to exchange information. It helps our children to develop skills such as oral communication, public speaking, research, and teamwork. This is a demonstration of your skill. This can help in boosting your skills in speaking, and thus your confidence will be doubled. So, first of all, I wish all the very best to each one of you to participate in this Explorations Fund for preparing this National Science Day Explorations. I know that you are making the best use of creativity. Congratulations. Albert Einstein said that education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think. May God bless each one of you to be great thinkers of tomorrow. There is great hard work behind this program from the part of teachers and especially from each student and their parents. Special appreciation to the parents for your great support. I also wish that this program may be a grand success. And thank you, one and all. thank you, Reverend Dr. Anil, for his for your great presence. Thank you, Father. Thank you, one and all. Have a great and blessed day. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Your presence and the gentle words of appreciation is a source of encouragement for all of us. It was great to see the children performing so well with a lot of confidence. Now we will see the next three classes. I call upon Emily of UKG Marigold to demonstrate respiratory system.
Good evening. My name is Emily Cherry. My topic for the science experiment is respiration. Respiration is a process that all living things go through to create the energy they need to live. Two lungs are the primary organs of the respiratory system. They sit to the left and the right of the heart. Respiration is divided into two phases. The first phase is inhaling. While inhaling, air rushes in and fills the lungs. The second phase is exhaling. While exhaling, the lungs contracts and the air has been forced out. The cells take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Now, I'm going to demonstrate about respiration. Thank you.
Laughing is also good for your respiratory system. Emily, you wonderfully explained the respiratory system. Next, Anvita of UKG Sunflower class has come to demonstrate the experiment, sing and float.
Good evening to all. I am Anvita from UKG Sunflower. Today, I am going to do the experiment, sing and float. Take a big bowl of water. This is a building block. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a wire. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a coin. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It sinks. This is a toy fish. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a rubber. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It sinks. This is a rubber ducky. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a rubber dolphin. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a leaf. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a stone. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It sinks. This is a toy knife. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. This is a car. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It sinks. This is a spoon. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It sinks. This is a pencil. Let's see if it sinks or floats. It floats. Thank you. Heavy things will sink and light things will float. Thank you.
Very good performance by you, Anvita. Told the significance of float and sink by an experiment. And the last class, UKG Xenia, has come to demonstrate air experiment. For this, I call upon Andrin.
Hi friends, I'm going to show you some air experiments. First one, no entry to the bottle. We need a wine bottle and a paper ball. Put the paper ball on the opening. and blow strongly into the bottle. It comes out. Do you know why it happens? It is because of the difference in air pressure inside and outside the bottle. Next one, the mighty balloon. Take two balloons, a tie like this, and blow between these two balloons. Why did the balloons come closer? The high air pressure pulled the balloons together. Next one. The magical egg. We need a white bottle, egg, and matchsticks. Light a matchstick and put in the pot. Keep the egg on the top. See the magic. Why did the egg goes in the hot air pressure in the bottle? Pull the egg inside. Hope you enjoyed the experiments. Thank you.
A breath of fresh air is a great thing to take and an even better thing to be. Yes, Andrin, very well said. Fun science experiments for kids are often full of surprises. These experiments also broaden our knowledge that science offers answers to various questions we ask out of curiosity, and we need to understand the importance of science. Here I invite our parent representative, Ms. Smitha John, to grace the occasion by her words.
Good evening, all. We are celebrating National Science Day every year on February 28th in our country to celebrate the discovery of the Raman effect. India's great scientist C.V. Raman, who invented Raman effect. This year, we are celebrating with a special motto, that is integrated approach in science and technology for sustainable future. In this is the best time to give push for a collaborative approach or an integrated approach among all the departments, because we are struggling in the pandemic for the survival of the humanity. My advice for the tiny tots is that they have to develop the culture of integration or collaboration to make big inventories for our mankind. I also congratulate the students, teachers, and management for making this platform for celebrating the National Science Day. This platform helps the child to experiment and explore science. The qualities to become scientists, they have to observe every day. You have to look our surroundings and see what are the changes they are happening. And you have to a mind or a thinking process. You have to undergo a thinking process. Why this is happening so? Why it's so? You have to analyze the situation. And you have to be patient on the results that you are obtaining. Although a scientist's job, it's a very tough and tedious also. You have to, every day, you have to update your knowledge and you have to think a lot for discovering or inventing something. So I wish many of you become a scientist and pursue science as their career. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing with us your thoughts. I would like to call Ms. Anjana to present the word of thanks and officially wind up the event.
A very warm good evening to all. It's an esteemed honor to propose the word of thanks on this special day. On behalf of Devamatha CMI UKG department, I extend my sincere gratitude to our chief guest, Reverend Dr. Anil Kongot CMI, an eminent educationalist who gave his vital time from his busy schedule to grace this occasion. Today, we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this will surely be going to encourage us in our future events. Thank you, dear Father. I extend my heartfelt thanks to our provincial and manager of our school, Reverend Dr. Davis Panikkal CMI, for your constant motivation at all times. Thank you, dear Father. I'm fortunate to thank our dedicated and well-motivated principal, Reverend Father Sunny Puneli Parambil CMI, and our dear vice principal, Reverend Father Sinto Nangani CMI, for their periodical monitoring and solid support in all aspects we grow. It is your words of appreciation that enthuse us in all our efforts. Thank you, dear fathers. Next, I wish to express my gratitude to our dear KG coordinator, Ms. Gigi Gigi, and all the teachers for organizing this function. I would also like to thank our PTW representative, Ms. Smita John, for your words of appreciation and for being here with us today. I must also thank our dear parents and grandparents for helping and guiding our children to do their best. I'm also very grateful to our technical staff and non-teaching staff for their great support and constant motivation always. Finally, on behalf of our school, let me thank all our dear students for their contribution for making this function a great success. It is your ability that made this day a memorable one. I'm winding up with a beautiful quote of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Science is a beautiful gift to humanity. We should not distort it. Once again, thank you everyone for your valuable time. Thank you.
Thank you, Anjana Miss. A good event never ends in the world. They take only a pause and keep us waiting for the next. The classmates exhibition will be starting soon after the official inauguration. Have a wonderful evening and enjoy explorations fun by our dear students related to National Science Day. The links of the classes will be posted in your official class groups. All of you may join in to witness the first live performance of science by the students. Let us boost their confidence to speak on a totally different platform. Let us applaud them for their achievements. Wishing you all happiness, peace, health, and success. Have a blessed evening. Thank you all once again.